So I've been able to capture the other playtest with the other camera.
That'll be good.
So I wanted you to be able to have access to two rooms.
Gotcha.
Oh, and then it's over. That happens. I'll screw up.
Seeing a pattern here.
Flipper gauge.
Three, two, one.
Chase the guy. Boom, there it is.
Take it.
The stakes are game.
I'll try it. Very like meter for the orcas to go straight to the zookeeper.
We told.
My assumption would be that both of the orcas would have moved forward a space. You're swimming out. You're swimming through an orca thing. You're not supposed to live.
So Alex, is it different in your head playing as an orca than as a some people?
Yes, it is.
I want you to play Zookeeper once again. Let's do it. I want to see how you learn.
I'm still in the orca mode, you know? Alright,
you ready? No, hang on, give me 3 seconds.
Go on, we need 3.
How far, 2?
Alright. 3, 2,
what is it? Going on, else?
Go. 3, 2, 1, go. 3, 2, 1, go. 3, 2, 1, go. 3, 2, 1,
go. And do the orcas learn?
That just made it easier for them.
Or are you able to make
up? Well, the orcas is kind of like discussing what your strategy is. You just kind of have to see what other people are doing. I don't know, telepathy, communicate with your fellow orcas, that's what your strategy is. You can be tracking your moves in a way, you can be tracking their moves too.
Yeah, you have to know where they were last
and where they can't be anymore. But,
Well, I'm thinking that, yeah, everyone has to keep track of at least the last move of the ordinance as a way to think about next one or two moves. So there is depth, there's the potential, you know, there won't be as much depth as chess, but there's movement, sort of projection, so there's a potential for strategy.
I think I found a loophole that we break her first night. Is you can't return to the same space, right?
Yeah.
So why can't the three orcas just quite literally just circle around this corner?
There would be a point where the player would be able to enter and circle with the orcas.
We would love to see that happen. But yes, that's because that would happen, right?
I like that. Yeah, two people can stand still until they see the little opening. Yeah. And they can move. Yeah, I don't like that.
But no, it's good that you guys were able to find that as well, right? That's within the possibility space of all the motion, and it would pop up at some point. Because there aren't four organs. There's three, so there's always one.
I think watching you guys and starting out, it feels like random chaos at the beginning, like you have no strategy, you're just gonna move. But then once you start playing, there are like these glimpses where, like during that last round, I was thinking consciously very quickly, where was this person last? And there was just glimpses of it. There was some like random, like I'm just guessing right now. But those like moments of interacting with the other players, where they get moved, where were they, where am I getting moved, that was like a very fun moment for me. And that was I want to play again moment, because I want to practice and get faster. The more I play, the more quicker my brain can think of these four different movements. So I really like that aspect. You could get better at it. Skill-wise.
There's a lot of continuous tweaks that you can do to make the game more difficult as you get better at it, such as like you ask the orcas where they had previously been, and like that wouldn't be necessarily an option because orcas can't talk. Right, like that, and then you can also take out you could take out diagonal movement, and we've had Zookeeper was still able to win without diagonal movement. It just takes a long time. There's a couple tweaks that you can make.
We also had it where we had like a little animal that you're supposed to rescue in one of the squares, so like the zookeeper had to like collect the little toy before they could make it to the dying space.
We removed it because the objective of the game couldn't be to get a prop, but.
I kind of like the idea of taking away zookeeper diagonal movement, because that would make it. It would make a different game, at least with Zookeeper, because I definitely use that in my strategy too.
What we did is we took out diagonal movement, but we allowed the Zookeeper and the Orca to swap places.
Oh.
So you would have to, in order to get the Zookeeper out, you would have to land on the same square as the Zookeeper. And that became very difficult.
I want to see one play test that's got two of your design, but the more experienced players with two of the newer players.
You do that.
That's your call entirely. I'm too
numb. I'm going to be great.
A lot.
Okay. Correct.
Three steps.
Ben, did I perceive in that round that you stayed put in one during the confusion that you actually ended up not?
I think he ended up moving.
Okay. I ended up, yeah.
In his rebalancing act, he had two squares.
So with just these three playthroughs, did we go through four playthroughs already? I think it was four playthroughs.
Yeah.
Was there any perceived advantage for the more experienced players? Or would it remain balanced for the less experienced?
I think so, yeah.
I think there was some strategy on defense. I saw a quicker strategy for defense that I saw develop when I was playing. Just a little more sense of where I should go, where as a defender I should go. But then I went right in the middle.
The other thing I noticed is that Stone was telling me how much faster, so you guys just had to just go. Where other people gave themselves some time while waiting for everyone to go, okay, 3, 2, 1. So I think that there's a little
different. Maybe, like, why am I trying to win? Like, should I get a point if I win versus 5 points, which do keep for every time? Or are we just like a negative
team? I just want to live, to be
honest.
I think it's going to work.
Yeah, I think
what else do you want?
Some sort of motivation.
You survived.
You don't want to win the same person.
Yeah, it would be kind of nice if everyone else would drink water every round. Do 4 playthroughs.
Yeah, you should move over 1.
There's a tie. You just go back to being zookeeper and do a playoff pretty much.
Or do I need to look at a zookeeper? You stay at zookeeper, like, so like 1-1.
Yeah, whichever workout gets a zookeeper gets
a nice. Yeah, exactly. These sorts of things I think would be really fun. And keep that going, because I had fun when we were going quickly down the barrel. I was doing another one, down the barrel, doing another one. That's how this game's built, and if there was a point system, and we knew who was getting the next one.
I wonder if it would be possible for the zookeeper to not only traverse, get to the far corner, but also traverse back.
Wow, I don't want to test that. Do you want to test that one?
Yeah, you like, we're doing a point system, like, you could say I'm going to go back.
Just, okay, we still got time. All right, so we've got time to test that one.
Okay.
This is probably going to be the most luxurious play test that we have until midterm, because there's only 2 games to test. When we have smaller teams, that means that we've got more games, and so we'll have to try to work through them much quicker. So let's take advantage of the luxury that we have in time. So let's go ahead and try to play that test out. Right? And I think that, yeah, you should document all of the tweaks, all of the variants, because you guys have created a very rich set of possibilities.
Yeah.
And so I think that you can go ahead and keep track of. Let me turn the camera off and back on because I have some marks. When the playtest starts.
So I have to get
not only do you have to get to that corner, but you have to get back.
Get there.
And so this one is the very
objective for us, just strategy-wise, like, we should be focused on making sure that he gets in that corner. We should worry less about trying to get him on the way to the corner, but like, when we know the corner he's going to be in.
I mean, there's a lot of
times that, like, you get there, and, like, people are right, you know, on you.
Let's just try.
Because you're going to stop.
even with one orchid less. Right. There and back again. Okay.
All right, let's make a quick break and then set up the other one.